church said amen.
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 And amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Let us rejoice. Amen. Rejoice knowing, hallelujah, that your name is written in the book of life. Amen. Rejoice always. I say again, I say rejoice. Rejoice knowing that God chose you out of the world. Amen. You did not choose me, he said, verse 16. But I chose you. And Ephesians 1:4 says, we are chosen before the foundation of the world. Amen. We are chosen before the foundation of the world. How can God choose me before I was born? Amen. How can God choose me before I was born? He can choose me based on his foreknowledge. God has all knowledge. He is omniscient. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's impossible for me to think like God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. His ways are further than my ways.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
It's impossible for me to think like God. And if I already know the answer, amen. Amen. And then you are thinking like God. If you think like God, you already know the end from the beginning.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And if I already know the answer, the end, before the beginning, I will be number one in the world. Amen. I will be God. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
I would win all. Amen. Sister Isaac, I win all the lotteries. If I knew like God, amen, I would be number one. I would know the answer to all the problems, to all the answers. Amen.
Amen.
Because I with God, and I would be number one. Amen. So God knows who will respond to his love and grace. Chose us on the basis of his foreknowledge. Amen. That we should be in Christ. God already knew. Amen. That we were going to be Christians.
Amen.
He already knew that, amen, that where we were going to be, amen, serving him.
Amen.
Man, Spurgeon wrote, it's a good thing that God chose me before I was born.
Amen.
Because he never would have chose me afterwards. And some of us think like that.
Amen.
But he laughed. Because when God chose him before he was born, God knew him completely. Amen. Who he was.
Yes.
He knew him right then. Amen. And God knows us and knows everything about us.
Yes.
He chose us anyway.
Amen.
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 Amen. God already knew all of our imperfections.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
He knew what we were going to do before he did it.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Said so.
Amen.
And can you believe he still chose me?
Amen.
Amen. He still chose you.
That's right.
Regardless, amen, of all the imperfections, all the things that we have done from the time we thought we were big enough and bad enough to do it. Some people say, I don't see how God can choose me. But he chose you before you were born. Amen. Like Spurgeon said, if he would have never, amen, chose me.
That's right.
Amen. It's because of what? God's grace.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
It's because of God's grace and his mercy. He said, I choose you and appoint you that you should go and bear fruit. And that your fruit remains.
Amen.
Amen. This fruit that Jesus is talking about is not the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But to go out and win souls for Christ. Amen. Amen. We know the fruit of the Spirit. But this is not what he's talking about. He talking about going out but to win souls for Christ, but he already knew that you were going to accept him before you did.
Yeah.
Amen. So I see myself standing, amen, before God's people. Amen. And we have opened the doors of the church, and some preachers, amen, might come up with a sad story just to get you, amen, to come and commit. But is that winning souls for Christ? Those kind of souls, amen, that you got to coerce and to drag and to pull in the God kingdom of souls, amen, only there for a little while.
Amen. Say it so.
Amen. So that God said, he said he want them to remain. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. He's not looking for you to tell a sad story about your son or your daughter who passed, hallelujah, who went on and he talked to her father and said, Father, you know, he knew that she was passing. And he's looking at his daughter, and he felt so bad, hallelujah, that she was so young and leaving this earth. She looks up in his eyes and, Father, hallelujah, will I see you again? Amen. Will I see you on the other side?
Amen.
Amen. Just from that testimony, here come, amen, many that come in because they heard such a sad story. But God said, no. I am looking for fruit that remains. Amen. But to win souls, amen, for Christ, we must have those nine fruits of the Spirit. Amen. He's not talking about the nine fruits, but we must have the nine fruits of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, and kindness. Hallelujah. Long-suffering, gentleness, meekness. Amen. If we can go out and win souls that remain. Amen. We got to go out with the right attitude. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
So you must, hallelujah, have the fruits of the Spirit. Amen. In order to go out there and win souls for Christ. Amen. We can't go out, amen, with an attitude. Huh? We can't go out with the wrong thing on our lips.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Like we talk in Sunday school, we got to have love in our heart. In order to have this kind of love, people might close their doors on you. They might turn their backs on you. But you got to have that love. Amen. That don't turn away.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
That's right.
Verse 17, he said, I command you to love one another. Amen. That's a command. And then whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Amen. Not that he shall, not that he will, but he may. Amen. It's up to God. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
The Bible didn't say he's going to give it to you. Amen. He said that he may give it to you, whatever you ask, in Jesus' name. And then verse 21 said, but all these things they will do to you for my name's sake. They will hate you for my name's sake. They will persecute you. They will cheat you. They will steal from you. They will lie on you. They will do all these things for my name's sake. But look what Jesus said. But remember, they hated me first. They persecuted me first. They lied on me first. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. They even hung him to the cross. Put nails in his hands and his feet. Hallelujah. They spit in his face. The Bible says, hallelujah. They even had a mock trial for him late at night. Amen. When everybody else is in the bed. Amen. And brought false witnesses. Hallelujah. To testify against him. Hallelujah. But I hear Paul say, I find no fault in him. Amen. Remember. Amen. That they hated me first. Amen. So he tells them to wait until the helper comes. Amen. Wait until the helper comes. He will guide you. Hallelujah. Wait for the paraclete. Amen. Wait for the Holy Spirit. He will guide you. He will walk beside you. He will speak for you.
Amen.
In verse 22, we read, if I had not come and spoke to them, they would have no sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. Amen. I bet some of us, he should stay where he was at. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, now they have no excuse. We are not held responsible for what we do not know. But with knowledge comes responsibility.
Amen.
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 It would have been better for them to have never heard than to have heard then turn away.
That's right.
Jesus. Amen. It's too late for us.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, we already know.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When knowledge comes, responsibility. Mm-hmm. And then verse 24 tells us, if I had not done amongst them the works which no one else did, they would have no sin. But now they have seen and hated me and my Father. Amen. Because they are without excuse. Not only did they heard the teaching of Jesus, they saw the miracles.
Amen.
They saw the works which no one else had ever performed. Can I get a witness? But they hated him without a cause. And because they hated me, amen, the world will hate you also, he said.
Amen.
And then he tells us to wait. Hallelujah. Wait until the helper comes. Amen. He will speak for you. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. As I look at Acts, as we look at Acts 2, we know that the helper did come. Can I get a witness?
Right.
Amen. And we see here in Acts 2, when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind. And it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat on each one of them. And they was all filled with the Holy Spirit, and begin to speak with other tongues.
Amen.
As the Spirit gave them utterance. And there was dwelling, the Bible says, in Jerusalem, Jews, devout men from every nation under the heavens. And when they sound, and when this sound occurred, the multitude came together and was confused because everyone heard them speak in their own language. Then they were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, look, are not these, all these who speak Galileans? Amen. And how is it that we hear each one of them speaking in our own language in which we was born? Parthians and Medes and Elamites, those dwelling in Mesopotamia, Judah and Cappadocia, Pontia and Assyria, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the part of Libya, adjoining Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretan and Arabic. We hear them speaking in our own language the wonderful works of God. Amen. And as they begin to speak, amen, I hear, amen, some of them saying these men are drunk. Amen. Because they're speaking in our language. Amen. But I hear Peter as he's standing up to preach the word. Amen. He's telling them these men are not drunk. Amen. They're filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. They are not drunk. Hallelujah. When we read on, we understand that it was 9 o'clock in the morning. Amen. Your Bible said it was the third hour. Amen. The third hour would be 9 o'clock, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Can I get a witness? Amen. It's too early. Amen. Hallelujah. For these men to be drunk. Amen. But in our world today, amen, we got what they call brunch. Amen, an excuse to get drunk. Amen, but in this day, hallelujah, hallelujah, they were not drunk. Can I get a witness? For they were speaking, hallelujah, from the Holy Spirit. Amen, has got in all of these men. Amen, and they begin to speak with the Holy Spirit. And I hear Jesus say, wait until the Holy Spirit come. Wait until the helper come. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. They came. Amen. But the people did not receive him. Amen. Because, amen, the deed was evil. Amen. But now that we have knowledge about Jesus Christ, he said we are without excuse. Amen. If you know better, you have to do better. Amen. Can I get a witness? We're not going to be held responsible for that we do not know. But the things that we know, we will be held responsible. Can I get a witness? Amen. I don't know about you. Amen. I don't know about you today. Amen. I don't know the talent that God has given you. Amen. But whatever talent God gives you, he wants you to use it in his kingdom. Can I get a witness? Amen. You need to speak what God gave you. Amen. And I come to tell you, when I close now, I might not be able, amen, to preach like Paul. Amen. I might not be able to preach like Chris O'Dowd. Amen. I might not be able to preach like T.J. Amen. But I still can tell the love of God. Can I get a witness? I might not be able, hallelujah, to sing like the angels. Can I get a witness? I might not be able, hallelujah, but I can tell the love. I can tell the love. I can tell the love of God. Can I get a witness? Amen. Let us rejoice. Amen. Knowing that our name is written, amen, in the book of life. Amen. Rejoice. Amen. Rejoice. Amen. They might treat you bad, but rejoice. Jesus said, know that they treated me bad first. Amen. So rejoice. Amen. Let us rejoice. Amen. There is no greater love. There is no greater love. There is no greater love, no greater love. Amen. If you know heaven to say it. There